Good day, people. In this video, you're going to learn about the Realm database. And if you are a seasoned Android developer, you must have heard about Realm database. So I use Realm database and I still use it. You can use it for Java, Swift, Objective-C, JavaScript, .NET. It's really wonderful and the syntax is just simple. So Realm has other beautiful features like working across threads, encryption, even building live objects. And live objects has to do with real-time updates of latest data. There are a lot of benefits for Realm using it. And Realm was actually built for mobile. That is to say, they built it with the intention of optimizing it for mobile devices. Unlike some other database solutions which were not initially for mobile. So you might have seen other solutions for Android, such as SQLite. I used SQLite and I still use it sometimes, but you have to deal with a lot of boilerplate code. Though we have Room now, which is recommended by Google. Room is a nice library also. But for now, we're not going to be talking about that. Probably in another video, I will get you some good introduction to Room, but not for this. So we are going to be working with an Android project, just initializing Realm in a project. So you can go to the documentation and check the database Realm documentation. So we're going to be using Java, and here you can see very vital information on how to use Realm. So we have the step one, which is putting class dependency and applying plugin step two. So first, this class dependency is going to be in the project level build.gradle. So we copy that. We come over to our project. Now you have two build.gradle files, project and module. So you can either view it in your project view or Android view. So this is your project view. So you can easily see your project build.gradle. You can now paste your class path here. Then you sync your project. Make sure everything is fine and good. So now we go to the next step, which is adding the plugin. That's going to be on your application level build.gradle at the top. Then you sync your project, make sure everything is fine and good. So this is your, you can go back to your Android view. And now all we need to do is initialize Realm. And our advice you to do it in your application class. So we create a new class. That is the first. That's what's going to be run first, and we initialize Realm there. To initialize Realm is realm.init, but I'm going to show you right away. So you extend application, and then you override onCreate. Just like any other activity in your project, you just override onCreate here in your application class. Now realm.init, init for initialization. And we can run our application to make sure everything is fine. Yep, this is it. The hello world. So that's all. In the following videos, we'll go on to create a simple to-do list application where you can add tasks and delete by swiping.